So, a very good morning to all of you. Myself is Sunaina. So, today I'm gonna teach you about organizational behavior. So, this topic is from nursing education. So, anybody from you know what is organizational behavior? What is an organization? A group of people that work together, they form an organization. Yes, so organization is when a group of people come together and work for us for the same purpose, they form an organization. So behavior means, what is the meaning of behavior? So behavior is the particular type of the activities they do, is their behavior. So organizational behavior means the particular type of behavior or a particular type of things that people do in a workplace is organizational behavior. Okay, so in exact terms, let me show you what is the definition of organizational behavior. So yeah, this is what is organizational behavior. Organizational behavior is the field of study that researches the action of people at work, means how people work at a workplace, what people do at a workplace, how they meet one another, how they meet the expectation of an organization, means the it is the study of what people do at workplace. Okay, so now all of you know what is organizational behavior. Organizational behavior is the field of study that researches the action of people at work. So Stephen B. Robbins, a researcher who conduct a research on organizational behavior, how he defines this organizational behavior is, organizational behavior, as he says, that organizational behavior is a systematic study. A study of what? The action and attitude that people exhibit within the organization, where people usually work, how they work there, what kind of personality they show there, is organizational behavior. So organizational behavior is a systematic study of action and attitude that people exhibit within the organization. So all of you know now, get the meaning of organizational behavior. Yes. Okay, so let's proceed. Elements of organizational behavior. So we have studied in the definition that it is the action and it is the study of the action of people at workplace. So it studies the action of people. So people must be the element of this organizational behavior. Yes. So people, first element is people. People are the main resource of an organizational behavior. Organizational behavior is a field where the study of human beings and their behavior is involved. And individual differences exist with respect to perception, personality, motivation, and individual learning, etc. So it is necessary to understand the individual's traits and characteristics. For example, we are going to make a group. So the people inside the group are not similar, right? They have different personalities, they have different perceptions, different beliefs, and even different background also. So if we want to combine them in an organization, so how will we combine them if they are so different? Like for example, I'm going to give you a simple example. Like when you guys come here in first year, so you meet different people, but now you are in fourth year. Okay, so are you sitting with the same person whom you met in the first year? So people change, you make friends accordingly. Like you make your friends as per their personality or as per their traits. The same principle goes here also. So So what is here? If we want to make people work for us in an organization, we have to study the characteristics and the different perceptions and beliefs and the personalities and attitude of the people whom we want to combine. So it is very important to understand the traits and characteristics of people. So you all clear, it is clear to all of you about the first element, that is people. Yes, okay. So next, let's go to structure. So what is structure? Structure means organization. Structure means organization. Yes, obviously. So structure. Organization is a social system. Okay, any social system has its own structure, and that could be either formal or informal. The company is a formal organization. As the saying goes, man may come and man may go, but the company goes on forever. So this is a very beautiful line. What is structure? Means an organization is a social system, right? Different kind of people work here. They come, work, and then go and go to another organization, and the cycle continues. Some people come, work for their whole life, and some work for 1 month or 2 months or for how much time they want, and then they go. So it is a saying that man may come and man may go. People come, work for you, and then they leave the job. But the company goes on forever. Okay. So structure could be either formal or informal. Like if you guys are told to perform a dance. Okay. So you people make a group, right? You people just choose one person, this person, and this person in this way, right? But in a formal organization, for example, if we have to conduct, a research, for example, we have to check the qualities of each and every people of the group, right? So this is a formal organization in which we will check the qualities of different people and choose them according to our need. And all the principles of making this group and all is followed during this time. So you understand the difference between formal and non-formal groups. Okay, so let's move on to next element, that is environment. Okay, so environment, what is environment? In simple words, we can say that anything that surrounds us is an environment. Okay. So environment can be internal or external. Okay, so what is internal environment? The environment within the group is internal or external environment means the environment that is outside the group or within the organization. Okay. The internal environment includes, for instance, the working environment, the individual activities. Like I have told you, the environment within the group means the environment that exhibit within the group, within the persons, like their attitudes and their beliefs, etc. The external environment, it compromises the environment of the organization, means the organizational rules, regulations, customs, the procedures, etc. This all comes in the environment of the organization, that is the external environment. Okay, so both the internal and external environment affect the organization. Like for making an organization work properly. Okay, so we need people also, and we need a formal group also. Okay, so in this way, both internal and external environment will play an important role in making an organization work better. The last and fourth element is technology. It is technology. Okay? Technology means the materials, the equipment, the machines, systems with which the individual works. Like an example of technology here is this LED. Okay? So, this forward by using these things. This technology make things easier for them to work better. Okay. The company purchases technology tool for the purpose of production and services, and this is an important element of an organizational behavior system. So, in case of any damage or any malfunctioning of this technology, the whole system is disturbed. Like, for example, if your LED stops working, and in case my laptop stops working, so the system will disturb. You guys will not be able to see these lights on the LED, and I will not be able to reach you by PPT and all. Okay. So in this way, technology also play an important role and is also a very important element of organizational behavior. Now, the fields contributing to organizational behavior. There are certain fields. For example, you studied psychology in first year, sociology also in first year, and some other subjects like social psychology and anthropology. You must have heard about this, but it is not